Here's what's making moving news this month on ABN August 2012. First, we'll tell you which areas of the United States are seeing the most inbound moves and which states are losing people. Next, in Arpin news, Arpin helps two sisters transport a truckload of soccer gear to benefit disadvantaged children in Haiti. And then in news you can use, we'll tell you exactly what to expect with the end of the Olympic Games. It's all next, right here on ABN News. Hello, I'm Chris Kunzman, and welcome to ABN News. Household goods shipment volume saw a slight increase in 2011, according to the recently released American Moving and Storage Association's Industry Trends Report. Total household goods traffic was up 1% from 2010, which is less than the increase of 5% the previous year, but it reflects a continuation of the upward growth. Corporate shipments continue to lead the way, up 6.6% over 2010. Northern residents are moving south and west, according to the report. Residents are leaving states such as New York, New Jersey, and Michigan. However, Texas, Florida, California, Colorado, and North Carolina all saw significant inbound moves. New home sales in the first quarter of 2012 increased 16% over the first quarter of 2011. The cost of the home factors into the buyer's decision to hire a professional mover, with higher cost homes being more likely to see a moving van parked out front. For the full 16-page report containing a range of useful industry moving data, visit www.promover.org. Arpin Group recently teamed up with the Rhode Island retail chain, Ocean State Job Lot, to help two local teenagers carry out their effort to transport 20 boxes of donated soccer equipment to children in Haiti. Cassandra and Christiana Lehman, both soccer players in their soccer recycle program, collected 20 boxes of soccer gear this summer, with plans to ship them to Haiti for the children affected by devastation in that area. Ocean State Job Lot contributed to the effort by donating 3,200 athletic shoes as well. The young women contacted Matt Dolan, Arpin Group's chief operating officer, and asked if Arpin could transport the donation to North Carolina, where the U.S. Soccer Foundation Shipping Center would send the equipment to Haiti. Arpin has helped transport donations in the past and happily agreed to transport the extra large shipment to North Carolina for free. The delivery will be fulfilled sometime in the next few months. And we'll be back right here with more ABN News.
When you throw away money on wasted electricity, you're throwing away everything you could have bought with it. Saving energy saves you money. Learn more at energysavers.gov.
Welcome back. With the Summer Olympic Games almost concluded in London, you might expect that traffic will return to normal in the area. However, the Paralympics are running until September 9th, and departures are expected to last until at least September 14th. Restricted air freight and enhanced security measures by the Border Agency and Customs Departments will continue to operate through mid-September. Potential delays during customs clearance will occur, with the Olympic family taking priority after the Games. Long delays are to be expected, and vehicles transporting heavy goods may not be allowed into certain areas. If you expect to be moving or traveling in the area, you should plan for the following conditions, which include an increase in parking costs, additional storage and shuttle costs, loading and unloading restrictions, and possible overtime charges. If you have any questions about your move, please contact your local Arpin representative. And that's our broadcast for this August. Thanks for being with us. I'm Chris Kunzman, and we hope to see you back here next month for another edition of ABN News.